In this closer look, we'll show you how to calculate stoichiometry problems involving limiting reactants. A limiting reactant is one that is completely used up in a reaction, and therefore it determines the amount of product that is possible to create in that reaction. An excess reactant is one that is not used up and has material left over after a reaction is complete. A problem may not explicitly state that it will require a limiting reactant calculation to solve it, but you can identify these problems because they ask you to figure out how much product can be formed, and they give you the amount of both reactants in the problem, as opposed to just one, which will require an extra step to solve. There are a few steps involved in solving a limiting reactant problem. First, you must have a balanced equation. Then, you do two stoichiometric calculations, one for each reactant. Those two calculations will allow you to determine the amount of product that can be formed by each reactant. Whichever reactant makes the smaller amount of product is the limiting reactant. The amount of product that can be produced from the limiting reactant is known as the theoretical yield. Now let's take a look at an example of a limiting reactant problem in which we want to figure out the theoretical yield of hydrogen gas that could be produced from 79.1 grams of zinc added to 25.2 grams of HCl. The balanced equation for the reaction is 1 mole of zinc reacts with 2 moles of hydrochloric acid to produce 1 mole of zinc chloride and 1 mole of hydrogen gas. First, identify the limiting and excess reactants. Then, determine how many grams of product, in this case hydrogen, are formed by the limiting reactant. Let's run the two calculations to see how much hydrogen gas can be formed by each reactant. Let's figure out how much hydrogen can be produced from 79.1 grams of zinc according to the balanced equation, which represents this reaction. Remember that when we're solving stoichiometry problems, we start with what's given to us, along with the units, and place it in the upper left-hand corner of a conversion chart. Now we can begin converting. After placing 79.1 grams of zinc in the upper left-hand corner, we bring down grams of zinc to the denominator of the next column. We convert to moles of zinc during this step by putting the molar mass of zinc down here. The molar mass of zinc is 65.38 grams. Then write 1 mole of zinc in the numerator. In the next step, bring down the moles of zinc and then convert from moles of zinc to moles of hydrogen. And we do this with the mole ratio step. These are based on the coefficients in the balanced equation. You'll notice these ones, which come from an understood 1 for hydrogen and an understood 1 for zinc in the balanced equation. In the last step, convert from moles of hydrogen to grams of hydrogen, and we use the molar mass of hydrogen to do that. The molar mass of hydrogen is 2.016 grams. Now the conversion part is complete. All we have to do is multiply across the numerators and do the same thing for the denominators, and then divide those two results. When we do that calculation, we find that if we have 79.1 grams of zinc, according to this reaction, we can make 2.44 grams of hydrogen. So that's one possibility for the amount of hydrogen that can be produced. Now we do a separate calculation to see how much hydrogen gas we can make from the 25.2 grams of HCl, the other reactant that we were given. Start the calculation the same way. Take 25.2 grams of HCl and put it in the upper left-hand corner. And then convert from grams of HCl to moles of HCl. We do that using the molar mass of HCl, which is 36.46. In the next step, bring down the units of moles of HCl and go from moles of HCl to moles of hydrogen, using the mole ratios from the balanced equation. Notice there's a 2 in front of HCl and an understood 1 in front of hydrogen. Therefore, put a 2 here for moles of HCl and put 1 mole of hydrogen here, and that enables us to cancel moles of HCl. We need to make one more column on the conversion chart so that we can convert from moles of hydrogen to grams of hydrogen, as we did with zinc, the other reactant. So 2.016 grams of hydrogen goes in the numerator. That's a mole of hydrogen gas, which is in the denominator. We can cancel out units for moles of hydrogen, and again, all we need to do is multiply across all the numerators and divide that by the product of the denominators. What we find with that calculation is that we can make 0.697 grams of hydrogen with 25.2 grams of HCl. This number, 0.697 grams of hydrogen, is less than the 2.44 grams of hydrogen that we could have produced from zinc. What this tells us is that not only is 0.697 grams of hydrogen the final answer, the theoretical yield, but it also tells us that the HCl is going to be the limiting reactant. We know this because HCl was the reactant that was completely consumed, and it made the smaller amount of product compared to zinc, which is the excess reactant in our problem. The next question asks, what is the maximum amount of water that can be produced when 18.7 grams of hydrogen gas is reacted with 22.5 grams of oxygen gas? Notice that this problem gives the amount of both reactants to start with, and that's a clear indicator that this is a limiting reactant problem. So we need to do two calculations. First, let's figure out how much water can be produced from 18.7 grams of hydrogen gas according to this reaction. Use the molar mass of hydrogen gas and bring it down here, 2.016 grams. That's one mole of hydrogen gas, then we cancel units, and then bring down the units of moles of hydrogen. In this step, use the mole ratio from the balanced equation, so that will allow us to convert from moles of hydrogen to moles of water. And notice in the balanced equation that there's a 2 in front of hydrogen and a 2 in front of water. So that means we write 2 moles of hydrogen in the denominator and 2 moles of water in the numerator. The final step is to bring down moles of water and convert that to grams of water. Since 18.02 grams is the molar mass of water, 18.02 grams of water is the same thing as a mole of water. Notice that all the units cancel out except grams of water. Grams of hydrogen cancel, and moles of hydrogen cancel, and also moles of water cancel. Then multiply the numbers across the numerator, 18.7 times 1 times 2 times 18.02, to get 673.948. Then do the same thing with the values in the denominator, 2.016 times 2 times 1, which equals 4.032. When that's done, you divide those two, and you find that you can make 167 grams of water using 18.7 grams of hydrogen. Now let's solve for the other reactant, the oxygen. The molar mass of oxygen is 32.00 grams, and that is one mole of oxygen. Using the molar ratios from the balanced equation, we have an understood 1 for oxygen and a 2 for water. So we write 1 mole of oxygen in the denominator, and we'll write 2 moles of water in the numerator. The final step is to convert from moles of water to grams of water. And when we take 22.5 times 2 times 18.02 and divide that number by 32.00, we find that we can make 25.3 grams of water based on 22.5 grams of oxygen. Since the 25.3 grams of water is less than the 167 grams of water we can make with the hydrogen, the 25.3 grams of water is the theoretical yield, the maximum amount of product that can be made. And this also tells us that oxygen is the limiting reactant because it ran out first. Are you ready to try one on your own? Here's the problem. How much sodium chloride can be produced when 18.0 grams of sodium is combined with 14.0 grams of chlorine gas? Here is the balanced equation. 2 moles of sodium reacts with 1 mole of chlorine gas to produce 2 moles of sodium chloride. When you're ready, press pause, try to work it out, and then press play to see if you got it right. If you got 23.1 grams of sodium chloride as the theoretical yield, the amount of product you can make, then that is correct. Here's how we got there. To see how much sodium chloride we could make from 18.0 grams of sodium, we first brought down our units of grams of sodium and used the molar mass of sodium to convert to moles of sodium. Then we brought down our units of moles of sodium, and in this step, we used the mole ratios from the balanced equation to convert from moles of sodium to moles of sodium chloride. Next, we brought down our units of moles of sodium chloride and used the molar mass of sodium chloride to convert from moles of sodium chloride to grams of sodium chloride. When we multiplied 18.0 times 2 times 58.44, we got 2,103.84. Then we divided that by 46, which was just 23 times 2, and we found that the amount of sodium chloride that could be produced from 18.0 grams of sodium, according to this reaction, is 45.7 grams. For the other reactant, the chlorine gas, we took what we were given, the 14.0 grams of chlorine gas, and placed it in the upper left-hand corner of the conversion chart, and brought down units of grams of chlorine to the denominator of the next column. We used the molar mass of chlorine gas to convert from grams to moles. Then we brought down the units of moles of chlorine to the denominator of the next column. And in this step, we used the mole ratios from the balanced equation to convert from moles of chlorine to moles of sodium chloride. Finally, we brought down the units of moles of sodium chloride to the denominator of the next column and used the molar mass of sodium chloride to convert from moles of sodium chloride to grams of sodium chloride. When we multiplied 14.0 times 2 times 58.44, we got 1,636.32. And when we divided that by 70.9, we found the answer of 23.1 grams of sodium chloride after rounding to 3 significant figures. 23.1 grams of sodium chloride produced by the chlorine is less than 45.7 grams of sodium chloride produced by the sodium. So chlorine is the limiting reactant, and 23.1 grams of sodium chloride is the theoretical yield. If you'd like more Chemistry Matters, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.